Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah is the one who raised the heavens, the skies. بِغَيْرِ نَعْمَةٍ تَرَوْنَا without the pillars, which we can see very well. ثُمَّ سَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ then he take over the universe or the creation through the arch. Some people are making a blasphemy or they are literalists. They try to translate astawa al-arsh means that Allah is sitting on the throne. That is mushabiyah. That is shirk. Allah is free from sitting. Allah is free from any attribute of a human attribute. Istawa al-arsh means it is that Allah controls the creation through the headquarter to arsh. Earth is the headquarter for the creation. We are on the earth. Earth is spherical. We see the sky. We go below the earth. We can see the sky. So the sky should be spherical. And the Prophet Muhammad told us in the Quran witness that there are seven sky, one above another. And above the seven sky is the throne or the arch. And arch is the control head. Arch is the headquarter for the universe. And arch is the Lohe Mahfuz, which is the hard disk, which is the programming disk on the earth. So Allah is not sitting on the arsh, na'uzu billah, ma'azallah, nastaghfirullah. Rather, Allah controls the arsh, Allah controls the universe through the arsh, through the throne. Like in Pakistan, the Prime Minister is Imran Khan. And we say, the Imran Khan is sitting on the chair. But there is no chair when Imran Khan sits. But it is a metaphorical, the Imran Khan is the Prime Minister of Pakistan. That's the meaning that he's sitting on the chair. But there is no chair there in a Prime Minister house. So this is the one of the fitna among the Muslims, especially even in the Philippines. There are lots of debate going on. The istawa ala al-arsh meaning that Allah is holding the kingdom of the creation. And arsh is the control tower. The arsh is the control headquarter where Allah controls the universe. Allah is infinite. When there was no heaven and earth and there is no arsh and no creation, Allah was unlimited. So do Allah become unlimited now? Allah is still unlimited. Allah is still infinite. No beginning, no end for Allah. Even how big is the universe, which is estimated like 146 billion light years, the circumference of the universe, but it still is a limited creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 146 billion light years, the circumference of the universe. But still the universe is limited. Being of creation created by Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Zat of Allah, the self of Allah is free from limitation. Once you make a limitation to Allah, you are committing shirk. We believe in a God, unlimited God. No limit for God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I was a child, our maid was telling me the story in Pakistan, in Karachi. Our maid, old maid, she tell me the story. She said, when you go to Kaaba in Makkah, there is a Kaaba there. Allah is inside the Kaaba. Subhanallah, that is shirk. If you believe Allah is inside the Kaaba, you are making Allah limited. You are committing shirk. So do not try to make a location or a space for Allah. Do not try to make a zaman, the time for Allah. Allah is free from the space and Allah is free from the time. That's why our aqidah, Allahu la zamanu, Allahu la makan. Allah has no space of need and Allah has no need for a time. That's why we call Allah Samad. Allah is free from time and space. But the opposite of Samad is Sanam, the idol. Idol need the time and idol need the space. You need to put idol somewhere. Do Allah need to put somewhere? While He's unlimited, He's unlimited, He's infinite. He has no beginning and no end. So that this kind of thing should not be taken literal, rather metaphorical. Like example, there is a hadith. When you are trying to get the close of Allah, the closeness of Allah, the qurb of Allah, then Allah said in the hadith Qudsi that if you come to Allah one hand, Allah comes to you two hands. But it's not geographically, it's metaphorically. That if you like to close to Allah, Allah loves to be close to you more. Then it says there in the end of the hadith, if you come to Allah by walking, then Allah comes to you by running. But it's not literal, it's metaphorical. Allah is free from running, subhanAllah. Allah doesn't need to walk or run, subhanAllah. But it's meaning to say, if you come to Allah by walking, then Allah comes to you by running. It means to say, if you love to be get close to Allah, then Allah loves to be more close to you. That's not geographical, that's metaphorical. That's how the showing Allah love to us. That if you like to be closeness of Allah, with a heart, then Allah likes to be more close and more loving to you. If you are loving to Allah, then Allah likes to be more loving to you. So there are the things which is Allah told us that they are mutashabihat, not to go deep on that and to make fitna, rather to not to go literal, but try to understand these are the metaphorical things. May Allah guide us, may Allah forgive us. In Allah, wa malaikatu salluna ala nabi, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima.